Hey guys, so the topic we're going to go over today is the effects of cell phone use on walking. Now, why specifically with cell phone use? Well, it's because almost everyone in the US owns a cell phone. According to a survey, 92% of adults own any type of cell phone, and of those users, 77% are smartphone users. And these statistics are only forecast to go up. This data is no surprise as there are so many different uses for the cell phone, especially with the increasing amount of apps being created and improved. While there are so many benefits to using one, there are also some risks to cell phone use, especially when used during another activity, the most popular being the infamous texting and driving. In the United States, approximately 9 people are killed and more than 1,000 are injured from this activity in a single day. But I'm sure you already know how prevalent the consequences of distracting driving are, it's more popularly termed texting and driving. But how about texting and walking? This is a topic that isn't talked about as much. As mentioned earlier, phones are used for much more than texting and calling nowadays, and they involve also the use of social networking apps and even games. So we are going to categorize the general use of cell phones while walking as distracted walking. Now the question you may be asking yourself is, just how much of an impact does distracted walking have on our society? Well, based on a study from researchers in Ohio State University, they sampled injury reports from 100 hospitals across the United States. Data shows that there were over 1,500 pedestrians treated in emergency rooms due to injuries related to cell phone use while walking. Now, these were injuries serious enough to go to the emergency room, so the actual number of injuries caused by this activity may be even higher. Now, this research was from 2010, so what does a more recent report look like? Based on data from the Governor's Highway Safety Association, it shows that this problem has only continued to escalate. It shows that pedestrian deaths have rose 9% compared to 2015, reaching almost 6,000 people killed. So, while numbers for distracted driving seem to have started to flatten out, the data for distracted walking continue to rise. Now, why does this happen? While each task alone is relatively simple and automatic to some people, trying to do them together is considered a dual task activity, which divides and decreases our attention, especially of our surroundings and environment, which can lead to injury. While we would like to think that we are good multitaskers, true multitasking is a myth. The brain cannot work on different tasks at the same exact time. This phenomenon has been demonstrated in multiple studies looking at cell phone use during walking. Most of the research concludes with changes in walking when using a phone. My colleagues and I even performed a small research experiment to test this. We had a couple young adults walk with no cell phone, walk while texting, and walk while talking on the phone. We recorded this data on the gait ray, which is a mat which measures where the foot lands during walking to see if there were any differences between these types of activities. Based on the data, we found that there were differences in walking with no cell phone use versus walking while texting and walking while talking. However, there is no difference between the texting and the talking on the phone. This basically shows that cell phone use, whether it's talking or texting on the phone, has an impact on the way we walk. This supports other studies looking at this topic. Overall, while I would not straight up say that cell phone use should be prohibited when in the outdoor environment, there should be more awareness brought to the dangers of distracted walking. I hope you guys were able to become more aware of this issue and were able to get something from this video. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Bye-bye.